Gareth Edwards The Creator tells the story of an ex-soldier caught in the middle of a war between the human race and an advanced artificial intelligence. By far the biggest selling point of this movie is that it's a massive original sci-fi story. The visuals in this thing are genuinely gorgeous, and the world building is really interesting. The movie is set only 40 years in the future, but in a version of our world where we advance robotic technology way beyond where we have in the real world. So it's a world that can feel really familiar to the world we live in now, but with some pretty major technological differences. For the visual spectacle alone, I do think The Creator is worth seeing on the big screen, but I do have some pretty major issues with it. Despite being an original story, it kind of feels like anything but. While I think the visuals are legitimately great, they are pretty familiar to the futuristic Asian settings that Gareth Edwards used in Rogue One. Using a big sci-fi story to explore themes of oppression is something that's been done countless times before, and mine to much better effect. And the central story is very much reminiscent of Lone Wolf and Cub, which seems to have re-emerged in prominence following the success of The Mandalorian Season 1. So I was a little bummed out while watching The Creator and realizing it's pulling from movies that accomplished the same exact things much more successfully. I also think that John David Washington was miscast as the movie's lead protagonist.
I'm the protagonist.
He's not bad, but I don't think he's been able to find a role that plays to his strengths since breaking out in Black Klansman. I think District 9 is a very easy comparison to make to The Creator, and that's a movie that uses its themes to explore the oppression and social inequalities of its othered groups much more effectively. And the central performance of Charlton Copley in that anchors that film in a way that John David Washington just isn't up to the task of doing in The Creator. There's a pretty solid supporting cast here, but Jimma Chan and Ken Watanabe are kind of wasted in roles that should have much more fleshed out backstories. And it was fun seeing Allison Janney as the villain, but she is similarly underdeveloped. I think the lone standout in the cast is actually Madeline Unavoyles, who plays the central child character Alfie. She's great, and that's really important for this movie because without her performance, I think this thing completely falls apart. I've also got some specific complaints when it comes to the final act, so if you don't want any spoilers, just know that I think this movie is about a 2.5 to 3 stars out of 5 movie, and you can click away now if you don't want to be spoiled. Okay, so I think the reveal that Alfie was created from the actual cells of Joshua's unborn child really undermines the arc of our main protagonist.
I'm the protagonist.
His arc is already a little muddied because he's supposed to be this callous anti-AI soldier, but when we meet him, he's already married to an AI sympathizer and has befriended her makeshift AI family. And then after his wife is supposedly killed by humans, he falls right back into his anti-AI prejudice. And then his journey with Alfie is supposed to open his eyes to the errors of his ways and that AI have feelings and deserve to live and have rights, which again is something he should have realized with his time with the AI at the beginning of the movie. So in the end, when he's supposed to make this pivotal decision to turn on his own kind to support the AI in the war, his decision loses so much of its power when he's betraying his kind to support his actual semi-biological AI daughter, created by his literally fridged wife, no less. It's a clumsy, clunky ending to a movie that I wish had explored its themes more fully. But that's just like my opinion, man. Let me know yours in the comments below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.